Alright. Now, everyone leveled up, except for me. Of course. Alrighty. Now we can start this. Where are we heading first? That one's very close. Those two are far.
Free to pass. I hope you're worth this.
Run like mad.
Bless us. I feared you were dead.
Just get to the hall. Barris will explain.
Fight well.
All right, when it's halfway down, we'll run back. Keep going. Keep going. No, I don't live. I'm a figment of the imagination.
Herald.
Head back to the main hall. We'll meet you there.
Of course.
So, what am I pinging off of? Running. There should be a third knight. Not a third night.
I hear fighting. We should return to the Great Hall.
Yeah, I know. Alright, heading back to the Great Hall. I believe Delirium was actually over here too, but... or something
we'll
was over
sure
here.
This side stays clear. The others need you.
She's not that bad.
Just in time.
How many Red Templars have you fought?
Some broke through to siege the hall. More will come.
Wasting time. I'm gonna go back up into the upper barracks because I think I forgot some stuff. Actually, I'm fairly certain I forgot some stuff. What? Why is Casboy over here? That's good enough. Do not need to get every piece of loot, especially since I don't think my bag would hold it.
Fort.
There was only one that time.
We'll keep the hall, Herald of Andraste. Show them.
All right, we have one knight and one Illyrian to go.
The Elder One wants her dead. Empress Selene, He hates her, haunts her, wants her dead, but hides. Why? He hid other things, too.
The Elder One has targeted the Empress of Orle.
Perhaps Leliana can discover why he wants Selene's head.
I don't know what I'm missing in that room. I know it is something.
This must be the red lyrium the Lord Seeker gave the Templars.
The same kind we saw by the breach. Where did it come from, I wonder?
The untainted lyrium Barriss told us about.
Missing a knight. Ah, the knight is above. I'm gonna head back to the hall, clear it, and then grab the knight.
Fort.
So demons are actually not just ranked by their demons and spirits are not just ranked by their power of what type they are, such as pride, envy, so on and so forth, but also by age. The older the demon or spirit is, the more powerful generally they are, which is kind of interesting. Alright, we have a knight to go get. At least some of them maintain looking human.
Maker, what happened to them?
Regroup with Barriss. He'll explain the plan.
Good luck.
All right. Locked from the other side. Good to know.
Yeah.
So is that one night that screws me up? Injured is Solus. Looks like, where did Barris go?
Right. Keep them off us. We'll break this beast.
Red Templars, coming through the barrier.
Ah, look at all those numbers. Coming in from behind.
The beast! End it!
Looting first. I swear, what takes the longest time is to loot everything. For the wool and stuff that you can't get otherwise. Need to down a dragon at some point, too. I think that was the only supply cache it is. looking for weapons. Swords. Bring up space for when we face the envy demon. That'll have to be good enough for now. Taunting laughter. That was more creepy than taunting.
I touched so much of you. But you are selfish with your glory. Now I'm no one.
Dark and desperate. Death to make yourself alive. I used to be like you. I'm not anymore. You shouldn't be either.
I know all of you.
Don't move her.
One promised you to me. Now no one will have you.
Move it. And that is why I freed space in my inventory.
Demon is dead. Andraste be praised. She shielded you from its touch. We've numbers across Thedas, but we let this happen. Our officers either fail to see it, or were complicit. The Templars are ready to hear what the Inquisition needs of us.
There was corruption here, but also I see valor, and honor in each of you who stood fast. Rise tall again. Help the Inquisition seal the breach before it swallows us all.
You speak truths we should never have ignored. But the Order is leaderless, gutted by betrayal. We must rebuild it.
Your order is a symbol that holds the people's respect. That cannot die today. We offer you an alliance. Supplies, weapons, grounds to shelter you. All we ask is you help us close the breach.
Do we take the Inquisition's terms, brothers and sisters? The Templars will come. I hope your stronghold is ready.
We'll be ready for anyone willing to throw their hat in with us.
Officers betraying their soldiers, Templars without leaders, a demon imitating the Lord Seeker. We should have taken them to task. The crimes they've committed.
Were committed by their officers. The soldiers of the Order will serve.
These crimes put them at our mercy. Yet, the terms of this alliance do not benefit the Inquisition as they should. You should have consulted us, Herald.
The Order was in chaos. We had to shape it going forward or risk losing it entirely.
An alliance with the Templars was our desired outcome. May we discuss their imminent arrival?
A few dozen veterans are coming ahead of the rest to help seal the breach.
How soon until these veterans arrive?
They're almost here. Templars don't like to be late.
Make us. Wait!
I came with you to help. I would have told you before, but you were busy.
That's fine, Cole. You just startled us, appearing out of thin air.
I wasn't air. I was here. You didn't see me. Most people don't until I let them.
Call the guards. This creature is not what you...
A moment, please, Cassandra. I would like to hear why he came.
You help people. You made them safe when they would have died. I want to do that. I can help.
Cole saved my life in Therinfall. I couldn't have defeated Envy without him.
But what does he want now?
I think he really is trying to help.
I won't be in the way. Tiny, no trouble, no notice taken unless you want them to.
You're not honestly suggesting we give him run of the camp.
Not freely, perhaps, but it seems a waste to... Hold on.
Where did he go?
I'm sure we'll find him somewhere.
Yes, we must make sure of that. I'll have people watch the boy. But let's not be distracted from the breach.
We'll need your help when the Templar veterans arrive. Take time to prepare while you can.
I probably just lost chances at what I was trying and aiming originally to do. Oh well. Okay. After that mission, I should have enough to, craft new armor for some of my characters.
Master Harry said we weren't to sell Inquisition blades.
What Harry doesn't know.
Travel safely.
Smithing is hot work. Here, have some drink.
Another
time, then.
Just double checking to see if I had had stuff made. Tons of lamb's wool after that. Much better armor. Now he won't be constantly dying. Not that he's died yet, but do I have enough to craft a staff? Probably not.
You need something? Let me know.
Something must be done. Immediately.
Nothing will be done.
Commander Cullen said the same thing. It's an outrage. There are mages here we know are guilty of heinous crimes. You would let that pass?
Yes, as will you. We are not here to coddle the Order. You are an ally. Act like one.
How are we supposed to...
deal with it. It never ends, evidently.
You don't need to tell me that.
I just don't know who told them I'm the one to yell at.
Is it that bad?
The Templars need to learn they have other uses than hunting mages. It's not easy for them. It is your doing, after all. You created this alliance.
Well, I hope it works. What other choice do we have?
Oh, I do sound like I'm blaming you, don't I? I don't disapprove. In fact, you did well. You made a decision when it needed to be made. And here we are. I wish I could say this was my doing.
We wouldn't be here at all if you hadn't stood up against the Chantry.
You're being kind.
You're discounting your role in this.
Let's close the breach. Then we can say how successful I was.
Dear God, being in this snow is like being outside almost. Oh, cold.
Cole, or whatever he calls himself, may have helped at Therrenfall, but that doesn't mean we should trust him.
I thought we agreed Cole could stay.
I did not agree. I was outvoted. I suppose my concerns can wait. We must focus on the breach. The Templars are making final preparations. After what happened with the Lord Seeker, they're eager to prove themselves.
The Templars aren't responsible for what happened at Therrenfall. They have every right to be here.
I do not question those joining us. Only those who betrayed them first. I knew parts of the Order were corrupt, but Red Lyrium? What were they thinking? If you had not gone to Therrenfall, there would have been no one left to save.
That's all for now.
I'm sure you have other matters to attend.
Yes?
I did not mean to click on that.
See reason, Lisette.
Commander Cullen took me aside to explain what happened at the redoubt. Disturbing news, but I'm glad you were there to intervene. Thank you.
I will talk to you later.
Walk in the Maker's grace.
All right.
Heard there was a big demon at the Seeker Fortress. Gotta say, I don't mind missing that.
Getting into your head, messing around.
What matters is that we defeated it and brought the Templars to our side.
With all these damn demons popping up, I guess we need the help. Anyway, with the Templars on board, hopefully we can close that breach. Damn thing gives me a headache just looking at it.
We got the Templars on our side. Glad to hear it. I'll keep the charges at a respectful distance. Not that the chief has any apostates in the group.
We'll talk later.
Yeah, no apostates in the group.
For she who trusts in the Maker, fire is her water. As the moth sees light.
You took in the Templars. You let them stay in strength, even after what they did. Their own people. It's dangerous when too many men in the same armor think they're right. You should prepare. It's already getting louder.
What's going to be loud?
I don't know, but there are echoes rushing back across us, ripples in a pond from a stone, but backward. But first, you seal it. I hope it hurts less. I'll help if I can, but I don't always say it right.
You helped me at the Seeker Fortress. Say it however you like.
I helped. It's good to hear. I will try.
I'll talk to you later.
Probably.
Oh, I love spirits. I love uncorrupted spirits. The corrupted ones, not so much.
So, the Templars join the Inquisition. Even with Cullen here, I never thought that would happen. Of course, after Kirkwall, I never thought anyone would use Red Lyrium on purpose, either. The Templars should know better than anyone what that shit does to people. Finding more of it really punches a hole in my Red Lyrium at the Temple was a coincidence theory.
How long does it take for Red Lyrium to grow? How fast can it spread?
It took years to infect people in Kirkwall, but no one there was actually ingesting the stuff. This Elder One managed to take the worst thing I can think of and make it worse. That's an accomplishment.
I'd like to keep hoping it's a coincidence, if you don't mind. I need to be able to sleep at night.
Honestly, I think I'll give up sleeping for the foreseeable future. I've got people trying to find out where the red stuff came from. I think maybe we should make that a priority. But that's enough doom and gloom. You just won a big victory for the Inquisition. What are you going to do to celebrate?
We can't know what's coming. Best not to get too comfortable.
I can't disagree with that. But maybe you should try to relax while you can. Things should be calm around here for at least the next hour. Take a moment to enjoy it. If the world's about to end, I'm sure the Seeker will let us know.
Sorry for laughing there. It's the anything but celebrate. It's like, I want to say that so badly. I didn't.
I didn't mean anything by it. It's good to see us all coming together to serve the Maker.
Never thought the Inquisition would be recruiting thieves to its ranks.
Good partners, I suppose, if they decide to stay and do what they're told. Seem to have a problem with that.
Whatever you think, they're the best hammer for this particular nail.
Well, watch your thumbs, because a Templar might slip or... You want about anything else?
I'll be back if I need you.
Go on.
Okay, let's go get raged at. Actually, I have no idea what he says. I've never taken the time to speak to companions after recruiting the Templars.
So the Templars will put their powers to use, sealing the breach. Any group corrupted by a demon must be watched carefully. At least they know how to fight.
We can't afford to be picky about our allies.
Point taken. Just remember, an enemy can attack, but only an ally can betray you. Betrayal is always worse. Speaking of which, you should ready yourself.
For?
This Elder One. You have now interfered with his plans twice. Once at the Temple of Sacred Ashes, and now again with the Templars. A being who aspires to godhood is unlikely to ignore such an affront.
Okay.
I hope the Templars are able to seal the breach.
You don't trust them?
I trust them to fight magic and kill mages. You built for them the Golden City, the center of all creation. And for a time you dwelt...
So have I even spoken to Liliana recently?
Were the Templars ever unkind to you when you served in the Circle?
Blessed are the peacekeepers, the champions of the just. Blessed are the righteous, the lights in the shadow. In their blood, the Maker's will is written. Is that what you want from us? Blood. To die so that your will is done? Is death your only blessing?
You speak for Andraste, no? What does the Maker's prophet have to say about all of this? What's his game?
I speak for no one but myself, and I have no answers for you.
You probably don't even worship the Maker. Lucky. He asks a lot. The Chantry teaches that the Maker abandoned us. He demands repentance for our sins. He demands it all. Our lives, our deaths. Justinia gave him everything she had, and he let her die.
I'm sorry. Her death has clearly hit you hard.
Not just me. All of us. She was the divine. She led the faithful. She was the heart. If the Maker doesn't intervene to save the best of his servants, what good is he? I used to believe I was chosen, just as some say you are. I thought I was fulfilling his purpose for me, working with the divine, helping people. But now she's dead. It was all for nothing. Serving the Maker meant nothing.
Maybe you have another purpose. I could help you find it.
No, this is my burden. I regret that I even let you see me like this. It was a moment of weakness. It won't happen again. Come, to work then. We will speak later.
Wow, I don't think I've really actually spoken to Liliana. Okay.
So it's true. Butler has stand on us. I hope my hunch was wrong.
You knew him well?
Not as well as I thought. Show me the report. There were so many questions surrounding Faria's death. Did he think we wouldn't notice? He killed Faria, one of my best agents, and knows where the others are. You know what must be done. Make it clean. Painless if you can. We were friends once.
Wait. What are you doing?
He betrayed us. He murdered my agent.
And you'd kill him. Just like that.
You find fault with my decision?
We can't solve our problems with murder.
And what would you suggest? Leave him be. Butler's betrayal put our agents in danger. I condemn one man to save dozens. I may not like what I do, but it must be done. I cannot afford the luxury of ideals at a time like this.
Now is precisely the time for ideals.
You feel very strongly about this. Very well. I will think of another way to deal with this man. Apprehend Butler, but see that he lives. Now, if you're happy, I have more work to do.
The snow, it comes through the ceiling. Okay.
Reports of fey drifts and demons keep coming. The people are terrified, and it's only getting worse. The only thing that will calm their fears now is the hope that someone out there can save them. You have to be that someone. No one else has any power over the rifts. Seal them. Your legend will spread, and Thedas will learn to trust the Inquisition.
Why do you want me to seek out the rebel mages? Why do you care?
I've known mages. Some of them were better people than me. And yet I'm free and they're not. It's not right.
I'll leave you to your work.
Wynn. I miss you, Wynn. Why did you have to die? She had to have been one of my favorite companions also to run with. Her, Liliana, and Alistair made quite the team.
Sigrid asked, told me that he can't let the herbs go for anything less than 8.
Nice work with those supplies. The smiths can use them to fit our troops with better gear. Might not affect you much, but our recruits will have better chances next time some monster flies out of a rift.
Farewell.
Make a go with you.
Well, that does kind of affect me.
You find anything we need, let me know.
I saw the leader of the bull's charges, that iron bull. He's something, is he not?
Oh, go on with you. You can't go making cow eyes at one of those oxmen.
No harm in looking, is there? Those shoulders, those horns.
You're mad.
Maybe, but I'm not dead.
You built for them the golden city.
It is good that you salvaged as many Templars as you did, my dear. We will need every Templar, but they will require proper management. We also need to increase our Lyrium supplies considerably. The Chantry may still have stockpiles we can use.
We likely need more than they have. Our enemies have magic that can rip open the Fade.
Indeed. We may need Josephine to open negotiations with the dwarves directly. The breach has done more than disfigure the sky. The veil itself is broken. All mages, no matter how skilled, are now in danger of drawing demons to them. Before this crisis is over, you may find that Templars, flawed as they may be, are all that stand between us and chaos.
It's a good idea to plan for trouble.
I'm glad you understand. Magic is dangerous, just as fire is dangerous. Anyone who forgets this truth gets burned.
You're preaching to the choir, Vivian.
Tell me something. You told me that you'd see the Chantry restored. What about the Circle?
The Circle has to be restored if you want to keep the peace.
That's comforting to hear, but you'll find opposition to the idea even among friends. It's something to consider, my dear.
So, Mahavir actually does have a backstory with mages. He does think certain mages should be free, but mages in general, he knows that power can spiral out of control very quickly. I really need to write more of his backstory at some point.
The Inquisition appreciates your assistance in this matter, Lady Corbin.
And my miners appreciate your business. You'll have your Lyrium by the end of the week. I should tell you, Ambassador, the Chantry raised some fuss when they learned about our arrangement.
The Inquisition must certainly seem an audacious idea to the Grand Clerics. We hope to convince them it is a necessary one as well.
I'll take my leave. Good day.
Who was she, Ambassador?
A merchant. I thought we should reach out to the dwarves to secure Lyrium for the Inquisition's Templars. According to Lady Corbin, it raised the ire of the Chantry.
Oh.
Access to Lyrium makes us rather more formidable than I anticipated. We're becoming a challenge. Sadly, the remaining Grand Clerics appear to be consolidating the Chantry's power instead of comforting the masses.
The Chantry should be a place of hope. Not another group scrambling for answers.
That must be its strength again. The Chants did much to bridge nations. Little but the Chantry ties Orlais, Nevara, Ferelden, Antiva, and even Rivain to a common cause.
Has the Chantry truly promoted such peace?
Andraste's chant is familiar across kingdoms, a source of many shared customs. That is the crucial point. Common ground is the start of all negotiations.
I suppose a shared faith can be useful when talking with strangers.
Precisely. And these similar interests are merely where we begin. We must learn to think beyond our own wants to secure peace in Thedas.
Planning to steer the history of the world, Ambassador Montpellier?
I believe the Inquisition is already charting that course. Which brings me to a question, if you have a moment. The remaining Grand Clerics sent a missive inquiring about the events at the Temple of Sacred Ashes. They demand to know whether the Inquisition officially claims that Andraste saved you from the breach. If it were up to you, how would you reply?
I'd tell the Chantry I was saved by circumstance, not divine intervention.
Yet as rumors your Andraste's herald grow,
The Grand Clerics may not believe such a humble reply. A difficult situation, and I thank you for your answer. A good day to you.
No, don't view me as a god again! Okay. Being quiet now.
You've brought back some fascinating things. We're putting them to good use.
I'll speak with you later.
Thank you again for what you've brought back. We will study that.
That was easy to get to level 9. I was like, yeah, I kind of want to be level 9 before I go into In Your Heart Shall Burn. But, guess I don't need to go questing for it then.
Hello? Can I help you with something?
You said you were a mage.
No, just an apprentice. I was never very good at magic. I've got just enough talent to be a danger to other people. But when the mages rebelled, people like me had nowhere to go. The Templars would have killed us. Luckily, Secret Pentagast took me in, along with the Tranquil I was protecting.
You said Cassandra has you researching creatures?
Yes. If you find anything interesting in your travels, I'd appreciate you bringing it to me. I may be able to find some weakness our soldiers can exploit when fighting various creatures. At the least, some materials are useful for making potions or gear for the Inquisition.
I'll speak with you later.
Travel safely.
Where do I want to put this point? And then I'm gonna go buy 4 respect necklaces for after In Your Heart Shall Burn. That way I don't have to worry about it. Oh, it's not directly after, so I guess I shouldn't worry about it anyways.
Maker, though the darkness comes upon me, I shall embrace the light. I shall weather the storm. I shall endure. What you have created, no one can tear.